My brother was watching BBC One, and I didn't want to see what he was watching on it, so I flicked over, and lo and behold, David Bowie was being introduced by none other than Whispering Bob Harris, who introduced him as, "This man I can see going far."
So I think Bowie's very important to everything in Brixton. Obviously his roots are here, and I think Brixton influenced his career. The fact that it's such a diverse community, there's all walks of life in Brixton. He really is a kind of icon of the area. He really used it to his advantage in his career.
A person came up to me and he said, "You know, I'm gay." And you got, he had tears in his eyes and he said, "You don't realize, for the first time we were not just tolerated, we were cool." So I think that made a difference between the level of acceptance.
So I think Bowie's look has always been a massive part of his career. He's not just a music icon, but he's a fashion icon. He's done lots of work in art and technology, and I think all of that comes together with his look. Obviously, famously, Ziggy Stardust, very feminine, makeup, dresses, which is obviously a massive inspiration for the gay community, for the LGBT community, and I think that is more relevant than ever in 2019. I think what he did back then in 1971 has continued to inspire people right up to today until after his death.
Well, Brixton is the place where he was born, and my opinion, it's the best place ever. So it's a sort of pilgrimage every year, and it's a must to come here more than going to other cities or places where there are Bowie events. I think everybody should come here in January, or it's a very important place for me.
Morley's store here in Brixton are the ones, actually, a lot of people don't know, are the ones that actually in 2013, well before David Bowie died, they commissioned the mural on the side of the wall in Morley's store in Brixton. And that's one of the, it's become an icon really that people come to visit